What's up, guys? Welcome to John's Tech. In today's video, we're going to be teaching you how to install Windows 10. Now, this works for reinstalling Windows 10, repairing Windows 10, and just a brand new PC installing Windows 10. Now, a few reasons why you might want to reinstall Windows 10 is if you've got malware on your PC, you've got viruses because you've downloaded some dubious things online, or your PC's just running slow. I personally reinstall my operating system about every 5 to 6 months. Because it's just easier that way, it keeps things running smooth. So, what you're going to need is a USB. So a USB flash drive, which mine's already really plugged into the PC. What we're going to want to do, we're going to find whichever drive is your USB, and we just want to quickly format this. Let's format this drive, yep. We'll just let that format. While that's formatting, what you want to do is go to this website here, which is from Microsoft, and you want to download their Windows 10 installation media. You want to download the tool now, just don't take a few seconds. Perfect, once it's finished, we're gonna hit yes, we're gonna minimize this. Oh, format's complete, perfect, perfect. Now we want to remember what drive that was. So if we do it like this, we'll be able to see. So it's gonna take a few seconds to get things ready, to find devices on your PC, and we're going to download Windows 10 ISO, and we're going to flash it to our flash drive, and then we will switch over to another PC and I'll show you how to install it. This is just a EULA, you can read it if you want. I personally don't need to read that. You know, I've used Windows for about 15 years at this point. I think I'm good on knowing what I can and can't do with their software. So while this is getting things ready, we'll have to just wait for that. So make sure your flash drive is empty. Obviously, if you're going to format your flash drive, make sure there's nothing on there that you don't want deleting. If there is, put it somewhere else. So now we want to tick create installation media, USB flash drive, DVD or ISO file for another PC. Because obviously we've already got it installed on this PC. We don't need it for this PC. So we're going to click next. Now it's going to ask us for these. We're going to untick this because it's not for this PC. So we want Windows 10 and we want a 64-bit. We don't want 32-bit. Most applications these days require 64-bit. Sorry, so we want to go 64-bit. So, click next. We want to do this to a USB flash drive. It needs at least 8 gig. That's fine because ours is 30 gig. I click next, and it's going to find my external hard drive. So I've got a games one and a flash drive. So we want the flash drive. Click next. So now we can just wait for this to do what it's going to do. So guys, now that it's done, it did take a little while, but that's normal. What you want to do is just click finish. This may take a few, several seconds. It's done already. Now we just want to pull the USB out. Now we're going to switch over to another PC. You do need to boot your PC into BIOS for the next part. So look up your motherboard manufacturer and check what key it is. It's usually delete, F1, F10 or F2. So let's switch over to the other PC. So guys, as you can see, we are now booted into BIOS. Your BIOS may look slightly different to mine. Doesn't really matter, that it works no matter what motherboard you have. So what we want to do is go over to startup, primary boot, and then we want to move USB to the top. Oops, I did all, oh, I've got to move everything down, okay. Let's just move that down. Network all the way down. As I said, your BIOS will be different, so you probably have this done a little bit quicker. All the way down to the bottom, hover device, that's just a random one. There you go, below. Perfect. So, now what we want to do is click F10 to save and exit. Let's click that, save configuration, yes. So now this should boot us into our USB boot drive that we just created. Let's just wait for it to reboot. There's the logo. Let me just switch your monitor back over because it went back to my other device. So while waiting for this to boot, guys, now's the time to disconnect your Ethernet cable. So you don't need to use a Microsoft login. So you can create an offline account. That means Microsoft's not going to use your email address to sign you in. So make sure your Ethernet is unplugged. If you're using Wi-Fi, obviously you don't need to worry about that because we just don't put a Wi-Fi password in. So what we need to do is just click next because that selects your region and things like that. Mine's English, so mine's correct. And then we just click install now. Now it's going to do like a setup, sort of checking what drives you've got on your PC, things like that. So this is going to find that I already have Windows installed, but what we can do, we're just going to overwrite that install. So let's just wait for this to go through its little bit of processing. There you go. All right. Again, it's the same ULA we saw earlier on the media creation tool. So we're just going to accept. Now we're going to do a custom install because we don't want to keep anything. So what we want to do is just quickly delete all of these, and then we'll make it all one drive, drive zero. Actually, whoops. Let's delete all of these so it looks like brand new hard drives. So this has two hard drives in it. So we want to use the larger drive because that's just my M.2 drive. So we're going to click that. So it's highlighted, click next. And now it's going to copy all the files over, which this shouldn't take too long because, as I said, it is an M.2 drive. So let's just wait for it to get the files for install. And I'll be back with you once it's done that. So now that's finished going through, you know, setting up Windows and things like that, now it's asking us for our region. Our region is United Kingdom. Obviously select the region you're in. Keyboard layout, yep. This should mostly auto-detect these things. Alright, so saying Ethernet's not connected, that's because remember we took the Ethernet cable out on purpose. So let's just say I don't have internet. I'm a Neanderthal from years ago. Now it's going to keep telling us, but you should have internet so we can push data to you. No, just continue with limited setup. We're going to get all the updates anyway because we're going to connect to the internet after. So now name the PC. Right. Perfect, that'll do. John's Tech. Password 1234. That's all we need for this. Confirm password. This is going to be wiped clean after anyway. We don't really want. Security questions, let's just put the password as all of them, because why not? Obviously, if you're going to fill this in and you want to remember these things, do put real answers in. But for this test above, we don't need to. Is that not detecting? Oh, I didn't actually select a question, I typed too quick. Okay. So, do you want them to have a location? No. Find my device. If it's a desktop, no, because it's in your house. Send diagnostics, only send what you need. I don't have any pen input, so no. Tailored experience, no thank you. No thank you. Right, just a moment. Whoa, my capture card is freaking out. Sorry guys. Let me try and fix it. So now we just wait for this. Sorry about the capture card freaking out. It turns out it's just that screen. If I click next, it stopped freaking out. I even tried changing all the cables, didn't do nothing. It's just that screen. Microsoft doesn't want people recording this, maybe? Who knows? I think it's just a bug. So, that's just going to take several minutes, I reckon. So, I'll see you in a couple of minutes. And just like that, guys, we are now in Windows. So, maybe later. Now is the time we want to reconnect our Ethernet cable. Just like that. Cable was shorter than I anticipated. I should have checked before I started. No, we don't want it to share an access. So now you can see we have networks. And now, okay, setting up my mouse, even though it already works, but that's fine. So now it's time we want to go to settings, updating security, click check for updates, and then just leave this to do all of its updates, and then you're good to go. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you in the next John's Tech video. So enjoy yourselves, and I'll see you next time.